James Taylor. You accepted my challenge for season finale, but there's a little twist, there's a little turn on this. Not only will we be going one-on-one, but I challenge you to a street fight. See, you come around here saying you're the king of hardcore. Dude, that was 2006. That was over 15 years ago. This is my territory, my domain. And I dare some old fool to come in here and try to claim my throne. You see, men like you don't make it in my world anymore. Men like you get beat up and sent to the hospital. See, I'm going to torment you, James. I'm going to demolish you, James. And I will make sure that James Taylor does not walk out of season finale 5. So James, it's time to put your big boy panties on and accept the challenge of a lifetime. Because now is the time for you to understand what era you're really living in. And that is the Anthony Steele era. And trust me, we'll be seeing each other very soon before season finale. And I have a couple things to say to you face to face. See you soon.
Special here, and here is Ledger making his way to the ring.
Ledger, like I said before, 2021 Razor Rubber winner, made his way to the ring, here to speak. Let's hear Ledger, the former man behind the paint, has got to say in the upcoming weeks leading into season finale 5.
I'm assuming tonight it's about what Gage Flair did last week.
Last week, a blatant assault to Daniel Cole and Ledger. Let's hear what Ledger's got to say.
Guys, I know last week in the main event, TBW Rampage, my opportunity was ruined. And Gage Flair, I want you to get out here right now.
Woo! Yes, folks, the former World Heavyweight Champion, the limousine ride, jet flying, kiss stealing, wheeling dealing, son of a gun, the nature boy Gage Flair, there he is, folks. That nature boy like strut came out here to confront the 2021 Razor Rumble winner.
I'm disgusted at Flair's actions last week in the World Heavyweight title match.
You know, disgusting would be the word for it, Scott, because he assaulted. We could have had a winner. But no, thanks to Gage Flair, what an assault.
Let's listen and hear what he has to say.
Cut this shit right now and explain to me why you did what you did last week.
Well, first of all, you just interrupted me partying with the Raven Boy Cruz Lewis backstage listening to Tokyo SOS, which can be found on Spotify.
Woo! Look, all respect to that, but that doesn't matter right now. You need to explain to me why you costed me last week, why you butted into my opportunity. Explain now.
You want an explanation? I don't gotta give you a damn explanation. I don't gotta give you a damn word.
You know what? Coming from you, I expected that. Now, on to the world heavyweight champion, Daniel Cole, since you're not gonna talk to me like a man. The Alpha knew last week that I was about to become and finally the TBW World Heavyweight Champion at last. And that being said, Gage Flair, I'm tired of you not respecting me. I'm tired of you always ruining my opportunities and always thinking you're better than me when you're not.
Let's see here. How many times have you had a chance at that belt? Let's go there. How many times? And not once have you beat me for that belt. You pinned me on one show, but you never beat me for that belt. Before you start looking at somebody and saying they're not better than you, look at the stats of the other person. Do you know who you're looking at? You're looking at the Nature Boy Gage Flair, a two-time world champion, a real world champion, by the way. That's who you're looking at.
Yeah, I know exactly who you are. I've known you for a very long time. You see, that's something that a lot of the TBW universe doesn't know between the two of us. You see, yes, Gage Flair, yes, Matthew Joseph was a mentor of mine, but...
How about you tell everybody the real truth here? How about you tell everybody, and look at that camera right there, and tell everybody the real truth. Why Matthew Joseph is your mentor. How better yet, let me tell the YouTube universe. You see, there's a reason why I stopped that match last week. It's because Ledger doesn't know patience. Ledger doesn't know patience. Once upon a time, I took you under my wing. And one thing you lacked was patience. And so I dumped you on Matthew Joseph. I dumped you on Matthew Joseph. You failed me just like you always fail everybody every time you come out here.
I never failed you. You failed me. You see, no. You got your side of the story. I'm going to tell mine the truth.
Watch who you're touching.
You see, you failed me. You left me. You left me.
And there's a reason for it. You had no patience. You have too much anger. And that head of yours is clouded 24/7.
You want to talk about maybe how I'm the fallen apprentice, but I believe that you're the fallen master. You're the failure of a master to me. You failed me.
You're the one that keeps failing. You're the one that keeps failing. Like I said, you have yet to beat me for a world championship match. And you, like I said, you got lucky last week. You got lucky.
That's not true.
You got lucky.
That's not true. The Alpha got lucky. But it was inevitable. The results were inevitable. The whole TBW universe knows I was going to finally become the world heavyweight champion and relinquish all the darkness and all the demons.
But I stopped that. I stopped that from happening. Because if you win that gold, I know this man. If you win that gold, you become something way worse than you are now.
You see, Gage Flair, you bring up the times that you defeated me. Every time there was some fluke or something had to happen. It was never, ever one-on-one. There was always Matthew Joseph interfering. Or always something coming up every single time.
That's where I'm one step ahead of the game. Each and every time.
I had your number last time and you know it. I sacrificed that world title and I sacrificed defeating you at that moment to finally get myself back. Something that you let that dark energy consume me.
I showed you once again. Learn patience. You see what happened? You're not the world champion, are you? No, you're not. Learn patience and then you might become world champion. But until then, you're not going to be.
Alex Cooper, champion. Get out here right now and give me a match with this man.
comes the TBW Commissioner Russell Cooper to,
come on, Cooper.
I guess, put a stop to this confrontation before it gets out of hand.
Yeah, let's see what the Bicon Russell Cooper has to say.
Okay, first of all, you don't owe him an explanation? Let me tell you what we don't owe you. We don't owe you a venue, Mr. Flair. I would be such a hypocrite. To Mr. Cole, you don't talk until I'm finished. To Mr. Cole, to Mr. Jameson, and to Mr. Steele, if I let your actions go unpunished, you honestly think I owe you this? The board of directors owes you this? The general manager owes you any of this?
Oh, you
we
know.
We don't owe you anything.
And you know. You owe me everything in the world, because guess what? Who's your number one man? Who's the number one man? I give 110% every single time I come out here. Even when I'm world champion, I wrestle every night. Where's the world champion tonight? Daniel Cole. Not here once again. Some champion. And Elk John wannabe? You better hush that mouth of yours. You know how lame you are. Always come out here interrupting everybody. I'm about tired of your ass.
Well, I'm about tired of yours as well. Especially you coming out and assaulting official members of the staff of TBW, and therefore, you will be banned from this arena for the night. And if you come back here, let me tell you about stats.
Looks like,
because if you violate this ban for tonight, you will be fined the total of $100,000.
Looks like you don't get your match tonight with the Nate, and hey, eat it.
You know what? That's fine. That's fine, because I do have some patience.
Learn it.
Toodles.
Commissioner.
Woo! Woo! Hey, hear my music again. I'm not done. I believe in.
Now, Commissioner, I know that you can be a reasonable man, and if I can't get my hands on Gage Flair tonight, then please, I know that you've seen the main event last week, and the results were inevitable, and every time that I almost put the match away, you know, Triple J, I'd like to get my hands on him tonight.
Great minds think alike, Mr. Ledger, because I had that booked earlier in the night, just for you.
Thank you, sir.
And I mean what I said about Mr. Flair. He won't get away with his actions. And as for season finale, I have a few little ideas running through this little noggin of mine. And I will come up with a solution that works for everyone. Have a good night, Mr. Ledger.
There, folks, the commissioner has laid the law down tonight. Gage Flair is banned from the area. And also, Ledger takes on Triple J and get a little bit of revenge against the offer.
Redbubble.com, honey. Redbubble.com, get yours today.
I don't owe nobody no damn explanation anytime, anywhere. I'm out.
And folks, here he comes. You know, I still cannot get what happened last week when he low-blowed Little Mike in the ring. I knew it. Once a snake, always a snake. And what in the hell is he wearing?
Here comes Atomic Titan to the ring.
Can somebody explain to me? Good Lord. Well, anyway, folks, here he comes. The Titan of old, if you will, stepping into the ring, and I'm assuming he's going to have a little talk here. Let's see what Atomic Titan's got to say.
Simon!
Shut up!
No!
Last week was probably one of the greatest moments in TBW history. When Little Mike returned and the shot heard around the world when I low-blowed that stupid son of a bitch from behind. I'm glad you're back, Little Mike. What I did was unbelievable. The fans did not expect it. And little Mike, I had to do it. You brought it out of me. Will you shut up? I'm speaking.
Paul Simon.
Little Mike, when you were wrestling in the minor leagues, I was actually a world champion and wrestling every single week, making a name for myself. Doing something that you couldn't do because since you left TBW, you became irrelevant.
Here comes the party animal.
What is Fat Age on here, Scott? I guess better to defend his friend little Mike, I would assume. After this jackass's insults.
That's right, baby.
Let's see what Fat Age is gonna say, folks. He's better to confront. Tighten over his mouthing here, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, come on. Another snooze fest. Another freaking idiot out here trying to interrupt me every single week.
Freaking idiot. You're built like a rejected Olympic athlete right now. Sit down and shut up while I'm out here. Why? What's your problem with him? What's your problem?
See, Fat Asian, see, you haven't been irrelevant either. See, last season finale, I curb stomped little Mike's head into this mat and I took home the World Heavyweight Championship, and now he's come back on a mission to take me out.
Okay, and?
Because I am better than little Mike. I always have been since day one.
You're better because you use cheap tactics to win. You can't do anything by yourself.
I actually have done things by myself. What have you done? You haven't...
Against little Mike, have you done anything by yourself?
Well, Let's talk. See, I have actually won many world championships, many titles, because I have these cheap tactics because I know how to capture titles unlike you, and I know how to make myself relevant. I know exactly what I'm doing. So you don't have to come out here and dance with the little kids and anything.
It just proves that fans love me, which is something you didn't have. That's why you had to change on them again. You had to change on little Mike. You had to low blow him so that you would become something again. You had to make yourself out to be something cool.
I'm gonna cry.
Number one contender.
You know what? I should be the number one contender right now, not you, for that U.S. title. I shouldn't be dealing with little Mike right now. I should be dealing with Ledger because of the Raging Rumble. I shouldn't be dealing with any of this, and I shouldn't be dealing with you right in this moment.
It's not his fault that you're dumb and you got thrown through the rope. That's your own. You got cocky over here, getting all excited. You was like, yeah, because you hit a running knee. But you didn't think, oh, I can still go out. He tricked your ass. But what did you do? You sit out here, you whine and complain. You go and find somebody to help you. You never do it on your own.
What am I out here doing? I did that on my own last week. Because it was the right thing to do. And you know what the next right thing to do is?
Oh, God, right to the gut.
Oh, my God.
Oh, come on.
A chair shot to the back.
Yeah, this is the Titan of old. I knew it. Wait a minute.
Oh, no, what's that music? Old-time rock and roll.
It's Bob Seger. Wait a minute. Oh, my God, no way.
It's the big dog, Gus Wild. He's out here. Making the save.
It's the original. This ain't no industry. This ain't no paymaker. It's the old school. No wonder it's some old time rock and roll. It's good to see the original big dog back. It's been a year almost, a year and a half.
I'm glad to see him out here making the save for Fat Asian. Wonder what's going to come of this.
I don't know, but who the fuck it? I know last week he threw his shades down in the ring, down. He walked out the ring, and there's a big dog-like, Fargo-like strut. And now, it's good to see the old school back. Well, it's like his song says, old records off the shelf, sitting still by himself. What's going to happen with this one, Scott?
I don't know. We'll find out soon.
Yes. Yes, that's been taken care of. Yes, Mr. Flair has been... Yes, he is out of the arena. He is out of the arena. Yes, he's been informed of the fine. Of course, you... Yes, he won't be back. I promise. No one wants to lose that amount of money. No one. Okay, Mr. Ledger was talking to me, and he wanted to know what you had planned for season finale after he had his Raging Rumble spot kind of screwed out of... Oh. Oh. Oh, that's an idea. Ooh, so you're saying Ledger, Daniel Cole, and Mr. Flair? Ooh, for the World Heavyweight Championship.
Shut up! I am so pissed about what happened out there. You let Fat Asian interrupt me in my moment and let that slimy Josh Whelan come out there? Are you kidding me, Cooper? Are you kidding me?
First of all, hands to yourself, young man. And second of all, it seems like you're feeling a little froggy. Feeling a little ready to hop.
I want Asian and I want Josh Whelan tonight in that ring.
You know what?
I will put an end to them once again.
Well, since you're so eager for a fight, I think you should have a tag match between yourself, Fat Asian, Joshua Allen, and you get a partner of your choosing.
Well, actually...
Well, he don't have to find one. I'm down for a fight against Lard Butt 1 and Lard Butt Leprechaun.
So let me get this straight. We're having the former mouthpiece of the industry against a former industry member and leader and the champion... And the number one contender all in the same ring.
Yes.
This sounds like ratings gold. Get ready for your match, you two.
The souls will be in my hands.
Thanks for giving me what I wanted, Cooper.
Next time, keep your hands to yourself, honey. Otherwise, you might not get it.
Advocate.
The advocate for the Alpha, the World Heavyweight Champion, Daniel Cole, Johnny J. Jameson, and the J's, he always says,
the Jackass,
stands for the Jackass, or Jackass. But anyway, we're going to be a rival of Johnny J, or Triple J, however you want to prefer it, ladies.
Wonder what he's coming out here to talk about.
Well, I would assume what happened last week. He's out, here he is.
Also, Russell Cooper stole his Raging Rumble spot.
Yeah, his entry spot in the Rumble. And oh, Hell's Mania.
He's been pissed about that lately.
Yeah, he's been irate. He's been pissed. Let's see what Triple J has got to say, ladies and gentlemen.
My music! Cooper, get your Elton John ass out here. What can I do now. For you?
And he just called out the commissioner, Russell Cooper, to get his ass to the ring.
Well, the commissioner, you need to be queued up and wait on the arrival. Already seen him on the early broadcast. There he is, the commissioner, TBW Russell Cooper, has to confront Johnny J. Jameson.
This is going to be interesting, Ross.
This is definitely going to be interesting. Scott, let's see what's going to transpire. We're going to break down in this one.
Better I be an Elton John lookalike than a beached whale, Mr. Jameson. Now, what is your business with me before your match tonight?
You think this is funny? You think this is some sick little game that you have? Do you get off on this? Do you get moist with perspiration every single time you put me in a match knowing that I'm not properly trained? You think this is hilarious? You just, ha ha ha, ha ha ha. Well, let me tell you something, you son of a bitch.
I don't think this is PG.
You ever put me in another spot like that again? I'm going to ram this cane and my foot together so far up your ass. Well, we're going to need to make sure we don't have a little cutaway of underneath you because you might get a little too excited with that now, huh, partner?
Are you about done, honey? Because I want to know if you get off on putting your hands on the commissioner of Tennessee Backyard Wrestling and the referees and wrestlers that you aren't involved with.
You see,
young man...
That's the funny
Keep
thing.
That down. Because you're going to be needing that after Ledger gets through with you.
See, that's the funny thing. You want to talk about potentially stripping my client of the title? Well, here's the funny thing. I let him go as my advocate. So I'm free to.
And quote Star Wars, it's Nash tackling Biggs, for God's sake!
Oh my God, he's going down on it!
Wait, he's throwing haymakers on the commission! That's a fine right there! That's a fine if I ever saw one! And now Cooper! Cooper now! Vicious right hands by the commissioner! Come on, where's
Matthew? Oh no, he's choking him!
Oh, he's got him with the scarf!
Oh my God, this is crazy!
Cooper's come unglued! He's come unhinged!
I wouldn't want to put up with Triple J every week. This is what I would have been doing.
Well, this poor son of a gun's got to. I feel bad for Cooper. No, you got to put up with...
Oh, he just laid down the challenge for season finale.
Well, that's going to be entertaining, ladies and gentlemen. Triple J versus Russell Cooper.
I got a little surprise five, what a match that'll be. Season finale.
And it looks like he just accepted right there.
He just said...
And now he's waiting on the arrival of Ledger.
Wait a minute. He took an ass whooping from the commissioner. Now he's got to take an ass whooping from Ledger. Well, it's not been a good night for Triple J.
Ledger challenging Triple J tonight because of last week him interfering so much in that match with Daniel Cole.
Indeed, he interfered so much in the last match. And Ledger is going to get some revenge on Johnny J. Jameson here tonight on the 2,000 subscriber special. And this should be a good one, folks.
Can't wait to see that Beach Will get beat up by Ledger.
And it's coming up right now in a matter of moments. We're supposed to get back to ringside for the opening match.
Here we go. The bell is underway.
And we're back at ringside now in the matchup.
Circling away, and he ducks that clothesline.
Ducks that clothesline.
And ducks the other one.
Ducks it again. Ledger keeps on ducking and juking and jiving. Oh, here we go. And now Ledger, ooh, with these chops, vicious like chops. The chop, the electric bill is being paid by Ledger. And now Ledger again with another chop. He's feeling it, folks. Clothesline.
Clothesline right there. And then here comes Ledger once again. Oh, what a big splash.
And there he goes again. Triple J now falling like a heap. Ledger robbing the crowd behind him. Full support, that is. Full support, I say.
Oh, what an enziguri right there by Ledger.
Ledger now taking it to... The advocate, Esquire, I guess you could say, of Johnny J. Jameson.
Johnny J.'s getting out of the ring right now.
He's taking a powder and run, but look out here. Look
at him. Oh, watch out. Here goes Ledger.
Air Ledger, ready for takeoff. He's hit the destination right on the chest of Johnny J. Down goes Johnny J. Down goes Johnny J.
Now he's stomping all over him right there on every body part, trying to pick him up.
Trying to pick him up. That's a lot of, as you just said a minute ago, a lot of beach well to pick up there. And now, look out. Oh, God.
All right to the post.
Head first to Johnny J. Jameson.
Surprised he ain't bleeding right here. Ledger going up on the apron right here. I'm guessing for a high knee, a knee right there to the chest.
Knee right there. Caught Johnny J. on the chest, like you said there, Scott. And now rolling Johnny J into the ring on the canvas. Now Johnny J get up to his feet.
Oh, Ledger's trying to go up top right here.
He's going to the heavens, folks. Look out here. He's going to fly right here. Look out, Ledger. Air Ledger again.
Oh, Kent caught him right there.
Like he tried to caught him. He caught him with a like a clothesline or a punch or something. Couldn't get it there. Our cameraman is... What a job he's doing tonight.
Oh, the Richter scale.
The Richter scale splash. That's got to be a grease spot left in the rig. Oh.
Yeah, and he missed. Ledger moved out of the way there. Ross.
Good thinking by Ledger. He would have been a grease spot if he didn't move out of the way. God.
And Ledger trying to hype up the crowd right here. Here he goes with a moonsault.
A moon standing like running moonsault. One.
Two. Oh, he kicks out. Two. He kicks out.
Referee Kevin, you're doing a fine job officiating these past couple of weeks.
Now Ledger stomping on Triple J right here.
Ledger stomping away on every body part that can buy a guy to get stomped on Johnny J, that is. And now Ledger's still stomping away, working on the arms, the legs, the hands, the feet, the head.
Oh, what a nice knee drop there by Ledger.
Yeah, that bowling ball size head of Johnny J's like a pumpkin or a watermelon that gets splashed with that knee drop there.
Now Ledger's trying to go up top right here. Will he make it.
He's trying to go to the top one more time.
For a signature frog splash.
It could cost it, but here
he
goes.
And he got it.
All the frog splash connected.
One, two. Oh.
Oh, two.
He kicks out. How did he kick out of that?
He must. Effort. I give him an E for effort. And now Ledger stalking Johnny J. Keep in mind, folks, Johnny J is a manager. He's not an in-ring performer. He's a manager. And Daniel Cole is not in the building at all anywhere. We don't know where he is.
Gage Flair has been banned, or he'll be.
Gage Flair has been banned.
It'll cost him $100,000.
Yeah, we'll hope we can pay him a fine.
Oh, here he goes with a Shining Wizard.
Shining Wizard knee. Right on the chest.
Oh, no. Whose music? Oh, my gosh. It's Daniel Cole's music. Is he here? Is he here or not, Ross?
He thought he was not here.
Oh, my God. It's the Nate.
Can't be here either. He's going to be fine.
Look out. Oh, my gosh.
Oh, come on, not again. Second week in a row.
Oh, right to the head of the jacket. Oh, my God, and Kevin.
It's a good night, Kevin, again. And now, for 2 weeks in a row, the Nate just pulled this stunt.
The Nate is unhinged here on Rampage.
Keep me out of the building.
He's making a statement.
He's been unhinged.
He better. His check. His checking account's not going to be looking too pretty.
You're right on that one, Scott. After this little incident.
Better hope he has $100,000.
Oh, by the boss, look to that code. He might be able to. Woo! I don't know. But anyway, Gage Flair making his mark once again.
They said, Daniel Cole, you're mine. Well, he wants Daniel Cole.
No, you know what? He wants the world title. He wants it. We both know that.
Will he get it back somehow?
I don't know, but good God, what else can happen tonight, folks? Tonight is it, Asian.
That's right, man.
First time us teaming up to take on, well, they called us Lard Butt One and Lard Butt Leprechauns, to take on Little Bitty Toothpick. In some second rate, whatever he is. But the bottom line.
No. You got it wrong.
What is it?
That's the formerly fired FedEx driver.
Right.
And the Grim Reaper who does nothing.
Exactly.
The only thing he reaps is our ratings on the show because he does nothing. No one wants to watch him. He's just boring. That's why it's season finale. I've got to take him on. But tonight, we're worrying about them together. It's me and you versus the world, Bubba.
Right. This is, folks, this is the Joshua Allen Taking Care of Business Tour. And, folks, we have just hit 2K subscribers, baby.
That's right, baby.
We hit the gold mine. We have got more. It's great. And after this.
Party at my house for 2K?
Right. Let's roll with it, baby. Let's do this. See you in the ring, chumps.
Let's go whoop some ass and party afterwards.
Folks, a tag match has been signed right now in your house. It's going to be Josh Wild and Fat Age taking a comic time to Joe Anderson here on the 2,000 subscriber special.
Got that right, Ross. 2,000 subscribers. Thank you all around the world for subscribing to TBW.
Yeah, we're
watching every single week.
Wherever you may be. And we're waiting on the arrival of the, well, I guess he's the best again. There he is in his little suit, for God's sake.
Come on, don't be making fun of his suit, Ross.
I can't help it. This goof, like he's running track or he must got a job at FedEx.
You know what? You need to go run some track and lose some weight, Ross. Come on, you're sitting here eating some donuts all the time and drinking some coffee. Well, hey, where's your barbecue sauce at?
Where the hell's the bottles? I've been waiting for months, months and a half, and the bottles were gone. Anyway, that's for him today.
You know what? I wish Roger Cross was here tonight to tell us some jokes.
Yeah, or maybe replace your ass. Anyway, here comes the Grim Reaper, the United States champion, Joe Anderson, who has got a matchup at seemingly five against Josh Wilder's tag team partner tonight, the Fat Asian. For the U.S. title.
Yeah, Fat Asian versus Joe Anderson, a season finale for the United States Championship. You've seen last week, Fat Asian won the number one contenders match against Manny Cobra.
Manny Cobra, the last broadcast.
That's a
to get his shot at Joe Anderson. Speaking of Uncle T, there he is, baby. The Fat Asian.
Here comes Fat Asian to the ring.
Fat Asian now makes his way to the ring. So we're waiting.
After the match last week, he party crashed Joe Anderson.
Right in the skull. The party was stopped. The Grim Reaper and his roster took out. And now we're on the arrival of the big dog Josh Wild himself, waiting the arrival of his tag partner. And there we hear Bob Seger's old time rock and roll hitting over the arena. And there he is, all denim. The white cowboy hat is back. And it's been too. Maybe he'll bring back the good old fashioned Bionic Cowboy in this matchup.
I'm confused about this guy. Last week he was telling fans to shut up, and now he's out here in the old attire.
Well,
how is fans gonna trust this guy?
Well, he might have a change of heart, Scott. He might have a change of heart. I don't know.
Change of heart.
He might have thought his mistake over. Here we go.
The match is underway. Titan and Allen starting circling each other right here.
How well do these two know each other, for crying out loud?
Oh, calling up on
tie up.
Here we go. Oh, he pushes him off into the corner right there.
And here we go with those. Here he goes. Gonna get them big suit bone hand like punches up. Oh, we go for a third one.
Titan's head must be hurting here. Oh, once again, now he gets off of him. Josh Round looks like he's trying to make a tag to Asian right here.
And he tags in Fat Asian. Here comes the party.
What's up? We're about to go to a Redbubble commercial. We'll be right back, guys.
We'll be right back and then to the commercial.
Do you want to not be on my I can't really see where did I miss. Ex-strippers. New killers. Shot. Tell him, this on Donda, on my mama, made a promise, Junior Watanabe be on my, Junior Watanabe be on my, tell him this, did he miss, Junior Watanabe be on my, I can't really see where did I miss, Junior Watanabe be on my, Junior Watanabe be on my,
over folks, RumbleShop.com to get all your new updated and old TV merchandise from your favorite TV superstars.
Yeah, head over to Redbubble.com right now to get your merch. And we're back from commercial, and Dan Walker is joining us here.
I'm here.
It's glad to have you back, Dan Walker.
And now we got this tag match back underway after that commercial, folks. And now you see Joe Anderson now making a tag to Titan. Now going to work over Asia now in the corner, folks.
Now it looks like they're going double team. Irish whipping into the other corner.
Here comes double clothesline.
Big double clothesline taking him off his feet.
Double clothesline by Titan and Joe Anderson. Now Anderson now working over Asia now, folks.
Oh, what a splash.
Big splash.
One, two, oh.
Two and a half.
He kicks out.
Asian. Kicked out there, folks.
Asian is the number one contender for that title that Joe has.
Yeah, don't forget about that, fans. Asian is number one contender for Joe Anderson's U.S. title.
And now they're slugging it out.
Slugging and bugging and thugging right now. At good grief.
Punching away. Oh, he's gonna kick him down right here. What's he gonna go for?
Wait, referee Kevin Sawyer.
Oh, what a face wash!
Oh, face wash. Foot right on the face.
He must be knocked out. Josh Rowan on the outside trying to hype up the fans.
Trying to get the crowd behind his tag team partners, getting his butt kicked by the Grim Reaper, who momentarily.
Looks like Joe's getting him up.
Irish whip,
look out, dumps it under.
Clothesline
there.
Asian's coming back. He's coming back. What's he doing? He's getting Joe up, looks like.
He's getting him up.
Slings him in the corner.
Oh, and a tag.
Tag down. Here comes Allen one more time. Going to duke it out with the Grim Reaper here. These two have never locked up before. Wait a minute. A Bionic Elbow there by Asian. And now Allen. There's the master of the Bionic Elbows that I've ever saw. What in the world? He's not going to cover him. What's this?
What's he going for?
Oh, splash!
Oh, it's a splash!
Oh my gosh, one!
Two!
Joe Anderson kicks out.
Anderson kicked out of the splash.
Also, don't forget after this is Leak Lewis versus Cruz Lewis in the main event.
We saw them, the two brothers, on the last broadcast.
Oh, what's he doing here?
Well, it's a
crossface.
It's a crossface.
Look at that. Look at
that. The crossface.
Titan trying to get in. Is Joe Anderson's moving? He's
crawling.
He's crawling right here.
Oh, he got it right. He got it right on the knee.
Oh, here comes Titan.
Oh, here
he
comes.
Oh, he's putting the boots to him.
He's pissed. He's irate.
Here he goes with the best lock.
Oh, he's locked
the best lock. Is he going to tap?
Oh, come on.
Is he going to tap?
He's got it locked in.
Is he going to tap?
Wait.
Wait, a roll up.
He got it.
One, two. Oh, I thought that would have been it there, Ross.
That could have been it. That could have been it.
It was close.
Thanks for joining us here tonight on the commentary team, Walker.
Yeah, you're welcome. Now, Alan trying to get to his feet. Titan getting up by the – come on, he almost got him by the hair. Come on now.
All right, what's he going to do? Enziguri!
Oh, Enziguri! But he's not going
to – tags in the fat Asian.
And he falls down.
Asian's pumped.
Now an Irish whip. Here he comes back. Clothesline to Titan.
Give him another.
Hit him hard there.
Asian now has got Titan down.
Took his head off.
Gonna move him to the middle right here. What's he going for right here? Looks like a leg drop.
Leg drop there applied by Fat Asian.
One, two, oh.
Anderson breaks it up.
He gets in there just in time.
Just in time.
Asian working over Titan right here, trying to pick him up. What's he gonna go for? Oh! Looks like a suplex right here.
He's not going.
He's got it.
Hits him with the suplex.
Oh, he gets it. Suplex.
Oh my gosh! Will Titan and Anderson win here? Will it be Allen?
I don't know.
And Asian?
It could be anyone.
Asian punching over Titan right here.
Allen is still trying to.
Oh, looks like he's going for the walls right here. The Boston Crab.
The Boston Crab.
Will Titan tap?
Oh, he's got it in. Now he's really wrenching.
Oh, wait! Oh, that should be an illegal tag Ross.
Come on!
And now he knocks down Fat Asian right there. Oh, what a big double leg drop there by Anderson.
That's true.
Oh, no. What's he setting him up for right here?
I don't know.
What's he setting up here for? Looks like the Superman punch right here.
Oh, come on.
Oh, wait. Oh, he pushed
him. Allen pushed him.
What?
Oh,
he
hit him.
Oh, no.
He just took a big punch in the face.
And now Anderson picking up Asian once again. Looks like he's going to go for a spear probably right here. Possibly here in a minute.
Working over the gut of Fat Asian. Punching him right in the stomach area.
Titan working
on
him too.
Come on out. Referee, do something about that.
Wrapping his arms around that rope right there.
He's got him.
There he goes. Spear into the turnbuckle. Oh, my gosh. And a bulldog.
Bulldog. Asian goes down by the bulldog by Joe Anderson.
What a match this has been so far.
One, two.
Barely. Barely kicks out. Almost a three there, Ross.
Barely kicks out that bulldog. I don't see how Fat Asian had the strength and the willpower to kick out.
Looks like Josh Rollins back up on the apron. He wants to be tagged in. He's tagged in. There he goes.
And now it looks like Anderson and Allen's going to square it off here. Looks like.
Now they're going to circle each other right here.
First time for these two able to face off in a squared circle.
Looks like a test of strength here, Ross.
Oh, wait. No, come on now. Anderson can't be that dumb. Maybe he's that bright.
Who's winning it? Oh! Looks like Anderson got it. Oh,
knee right to the gut.
And an Irish whip right here.
Irish whip. Here goes the throw. Oh, clothesline off. Good God. Allen is down from the clothesline.
That must have been hard to get down him down right there.
Two.
Oh, grabs the rope.
Rope break. That's, oh, come on now. Titan just kicks his hand.
He tried.
Try to stomp his fingers off.
See, these two scumbags are anything to cheat to get the victory here.
Now he's tagging him in.
Now Titan is in there. Oh, no, what's he going to do? He's probably going to curve stomp his face in.
Titan slowly, weasel-like, getting in the ring there. Against his adversary.
Trying to pick up Josh Rowland right here.
Trying to pick him up.
Driver. Looks like they're throwing punches. Oh!
Trading blows here.
Both been trading blows.
What's going to happen right here? Oh, Irish whip.
Into the corner. What's up, big?
Big shoulder right to the chest. Now Titans turn around his back.
That's a DQ.
That's a DQ right there. Right in the back. And the ref saw
it. And now Titans laughing.
And the ref saw it in plain view.
Come on, now they're coming in. They're both.
Here comes Aiden.
Oh, it's a chest.
Oh, my God. It's from there.
Is Joe trying to take out the fat Asian?
Oh my gosh.
He's trying to take him out before anniversary.
Oh, wait.
He's choking it with the chair.
Claymore.
Oh, the ref just got. He ate a Claymore. Come on now.
Yeah, he's trying to break it up and he got in Titan's way.
This is an assault.
Now he's sitting on that chair. He must be in pain there.
This is disgusting.
What a moment. Now he has the best lock applied on to Josh Rowan.
Oh,
right here.
Come on. That's disgusting. This makes me sick. They won the match by DQ, and they're getting beat down in the middle of the ring. That's not right, folks. But anyway, Titan and Anderson get the last laugh in this tag team contest.
I guess they think they're the winners. They're raising their hands.
Well, they lost. I hate to say them, but thanks to Titan's little low blow to Allen there, they didn't get the victory. That shows you how bright these two idiots are.
Come on, Ross. You gotta have cheap tactics to win. That's what he was telling Asian earlier.
Yeah, but come on, Scott.
At least they get the last laugh. You know what I mean? Now he's kissing him goodbye. Blew him a kiss.
This is you.
I see how you are, Scott.
Oh, and he just said he was the best.
Oh, good God! I don't want to hear that word again. Let's go. Somebody give me an aspirin. I'm gonna have a headache.
Well, you can thank Little Mike
the
for
fucking
this.
Best.
Oh, what do you mean, thank you?
And Little Mike.
Yeah, blame
this
Mike.
Happened. I'm going to show
it's
you
all his
why
fault.
I am.
Oh, you two are, y'all are unbelievable. Here comes fans. Here comes Little Mike coming down the ringside, I guess, to make a speech of his big return last week on the broadcast.
Yeah, I can't wait to see what Little Mike has to say here tonight on Rampage. I'm so pumped.
Well, you don't sound pumped.
What do you have to say about it?
Let's go. I'm excited. Yeah. Little Mike, wait a minute.
Been in TBW and almost 1 year since he suffered a concussion of the hands of Beast and Atomic Titan at season finale.
Little Mike! Little Mike burst through the curtain, and he's back home in the arena that he made famous. And now we're gonna see what Little Mike has to say at the actions last week of taking a low blow to Atomic freaking Titan in his big return and his match back. Let's hear what Little Mike has to say of last week's action.
Welcome back.
Man, it feels good to be back.
Yeah.
I didn't have much time to explain from last week. Wonder why I'm back, where I've been, everything. First things first, let's go back November 28th, 2020, in the main event against Ledger. I retained the world heavyweight title.
Yeah.
In the midst of everything, I suffered a concussion. All of a sudden, this big beastie boy bitch comes in with a chain, hits me behind the back, gives me that stupid uranagi, and then that little pimp squeak Atomic Titan with his golden vault catches in on me. You damn right he's a pipsqueak. And he just wins and steals the title away from me. You know, during that time, I was confused. Everything that happened to me in 2020, after the failure I did in 2019, I rebounded myself in 2020, working my ass off just to have a little pipsqueak. Just had to create his own match, make sure he'd be back in the main event. That's all he cares about.
Facts, 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 facts.
And now, last week, he thought he could be back in the main event by calling out Ledger. That's where he was wrong. He didn't expect me to come back. The look on his face was just priceless. Tommy, you asked me where I've been? Simple. I was just drifting away. I moved to North Carolina for a little bit, just reset everything in my mind. seen everything happen, made me realize I had to come back for everybody, hey, who you did wrong with. And season finale, I'll make sure you pay for everybody you did wrong.
Words by little Mike there, Scott and Walker, but we're gonna see what happens next. Next time we see little Mike here on the broadcast. Gentlemen, it is that time one more time. It's main event time here on the 2K Subscriber Special here on Rampage. It's brother versus brother.
What a journey this has been for both of them. I remember at Anniversary 4, Cruz Lewis put Lake Lewis in a casket.
Raven's Realm 2.
And then the first Raven Realms, Lake Lewis defeated his brother in the first Raven Realms. This is the third match between them here on Rampage.
Yep, this is the third annual encounter between these two Lewis brothers. But this ain't no Raven's Realm match. This ain't a casket match. It's a normal one-on-one contest.
And you know, I can't wait to call this action here tonight.
This is going to be one
hell of a match.
I'm honored to call this.
There he is,
the Knockout King, Lake Lewis. Well, I guess not anymore the Knockout King. He feels like his crown was ripped from him by his younger brother in that casket.
Well,
match.
He's proclaimed that crown here tonight again.
That moniker. I hope he does. He's got the fan support behind him. But what next on his younger brother, Raven Boy Cruz Lewis, to make his presence felt here in the ring, in the arena. Off the master of what? Like he's got some war paint on here, folks. He's gonna be on the war path of his older brother here. And like we said, this third annual encounter between these two brothers.
I'm so ready to call this action. What about you, Dan?
Yeah, I'm excited.
I don't know who to pull for in this contest. I'm just gonna call it like I see it, right down the middle. A classic bully contest.
Both have won one match out of the series. This is the final encounter of the Lewis brothers.
Well, I don't know about the final one, but it might just be the final. But let's see which brother is going to prevail in this third encounter.
Sounded, we're underway on the main event of Rampage.
Lewis versus Lewis, brother versus brother, third final encounter. Here we go, lock up by both brothers now.
Turn up on top. It's like he's wrenching that arm.
Wrenching the arm, there is Lake.
Oh,
younger brother.
Flips, comes back, wait, oh!
Look out.
Wrist lock of his own.
A wrist lock there by Cruz. Wrenching the arm, folks. Wrenching the arm there. And now, Lake now has his transition behind Cruz. Now Cruz transitions with a headlock now.
And now going back to the corner. Wait, no, Irish whip.
Comes back.
Oh, what a shoulder block.
Shoulder block.
Oh, and a kip up.
And Cruz kips up.
What a phenomenal start here to this matchup here on Rampage.
What a phenomenal start to this main event matchup.
Oh, another caller, another top. Right, doing the same here. Wait, oh.
Look out.
Flips. Oh, he
lands on his feet.
Oh, waist lock right here. Over.
Waist lock takedown. stomach first and knees on the canvas. Now he's got it wrenched like a gut wrench. Like a belly to belly, like top formation.
He hooks the ropes.
Hooks the rope.
Oh, what an elbow. Come on, Ross, sound enthused here.
What a big boot there. A big foot right on the face of Lake Lewis.
And now into the corner, Lake is. Looks like he's kneeing him right here.
Cruz putting them martial art-like knees. That's his background MMA. He does all these boxing and martial arts. What a drop kick.
Huge drop kick.
What a drop kick there, folks.
And now Lake is on the ground.
Lake on the canvas. Now Cruz stalking his older brother, trying to see what he can do next to maybe put away his brother in this final matchup between these three, as you said, Scott, in the night.
Elbows right there. What is he going to do right here? What is Cruz going to do?
What in the world? Yeah, what in the world is he going to do?
Looks like Lake's trying to get the upper advantage here. Lake,
he's fighting back.
Oh, here we go. We know what this is.
Oh, God. Middle rope DDT. Look at that. Oh, that's a head rattling.
One, two. Not just yet, Lake. Not just yet.
He's got to put a little more damage on his brother before he does fighting like that.
Now stomping away in the corner.
Stomping away. Lake to his younger brother. Now Lake is backing away, backing off.
Backing off because the ref told him to get back.
Now what a chop there.
Now look out.
Another chop. Oh, what an elbow.
What a flying like, strong style like elbow.
Looks like he's going for a.
Oh, release. Suplex almost.
One, two.
Oh,
I think that was an X-Plex.
That was.
X-Plex. Thank you, Walker.
Come on, Ross. Get it right.
I'm trying to. I can't help myself.
Oh, submission.
Triangle choker, a guillotine, it looks like. Yep, there it is. He's got it cinched. His legs right from the head, cutting off the oxygen supply.
Oh, into an armbar. Wait. He's trying to
Can he break it? He's trying to break the hold to fully lock it in.
Lake was holding his hands together, trying to not let it cinch in right there.
Exactly. That's what he tried not to get locked in that armbar.
Now he's looking over Lake Lewis.
And now Cruz, flood of steam. Oh, what a kick. Oh, good Lord.
Another kick right there.
Multiple light kicks. Oh,
right to the head.
Right to the head there. That'll knock you out.
Lake's in the corner right here.
Seated in the corner position.
And now picking him up.
Look out. He's got him up.
Oh, is he going to try a suplex of his own? Oh, my God.
He got it. Suplex.
He got him over.
A suplex by Cruz to his older brother Lake. What a suplex it was.
Lake must be in pain there as he's laying on the canvas. What a double leg drop.
Double leg drop from Cruz Lewis.
Leg drop there. Double feet to the chest.
What a main event worthy match here on the 2,000 subscriber special Rampage.
You ain't kidding, Scott. And now look at this. What's Cruz now. Here? A big elbow and forearms. We're going to get some strong style wrestling here now, folks.
He ducks it. Come on. Oh my God. He turned him inside out.
Turned him inside out with that big boot maneuver right there.
He's got to pin him.
One, two.
Kicks out after that big, vicious strike.
That big clothesline right there that turned him inside out.
Goodness.
And now Lake and Cruz both trying to get to the feet. Lake's on his feet. Cruz is almost, he's in the corner. And now Lake has got him up. Here come the chops. And the electric bill is being paid, cursed by the older brother here in this contest. And now Lake Irish whip into the corner.
Irish whip, here he goes.
Incoming.
What a clothesline into the corner right there. And now looks like he's trying to pick him up right here. He lands it. Oh, my God.
Elbows and forearms right in the faces of both Lake and Cruz.
Both men are down.
And by God,
where they get to their feet.
Who's going to get to their feet for it? Referee's up to four almost now.
What a match here on Rampage. This is awesome.
What a main event match. One of these brothers, we each, like we, last time we saw him, was anniversary four in the Ravens Realm 2 match.
Blake is up. Cruz is up. Both men are back up to their feet here.
Both brothers are up. Yes, sir. Walker, you're right on that one. What's going to happen now? Oh, what a punch there.
Throwing strikes back and forth.
Strong style wrestling at its finest, folks. These two.
Oh my gosh.
He rolling elbow. Kick
Cruz
the
with the kick. Oh my gosh.
Oh, good God.
Spinning kick right there.
Jumping spin kick there.
Now he's trying to get him back to his feet right here.
Trying to. And he does.
Oh, Cruz Lake pushes him. Oh, wait. Oh. Ducks.
Standoff. It's going to stand off. Circle each other.
Oh, wait. Oh, lands it again.
Oh, what a big boot
to the face.
What the? God, took the whole DDT.
And a kip up there by Cruz Lewis. Holy crap.
Good God almighty, man.
What a match.
What a matchup this is.
One, two, oh.
What a move there. What a kick out to the willpower that it's in the in Lake Lewis' soul to kick out.
Lake is outside of the ring now. What's Cruz looking overweight? He's going up top. Watch out, Lake. Oh!
A diving.
Four, man.
Exactly. I couldn't have said it better myself.
Holy crap. Now, they're taking risks. They're doing anything they can.
It's like a human demolition derby with no cars.
With your body.
No.
Oh, fuck. Look out now. Look out. Now. Oh, my God. Release suplex out of the apron. Back first.
It's like a release suplex X-Plex right there onto the apron. That, he must be in pain.
Let me remind you, fans, that is the hardest part of a ring. I don't matter, homemade or a professional ring. That is the hardest part you can ask anyone.
Well, you've done your research. I'm proud of you.
I sure have.
Now, Blake on the apron, Cruz trying to get back up. Oh, what a kick!
Security.
Oh, my
Lake
gosh.
Stumbles on the outside.
Oh, no. What is Cruz doing? He's observing right now.
He's observing this area. Observing.
Oh, my God! Oh, my
God! Got
on the ropes.
He just dove over all three of the ropes from the outside and lands on his older brother, and the both brothers in our. Well, like Lake is, he's in La La Land. I would imagine so.
What just that was amazing. What a jump over all three ropes onto Lake Lewis.
Jumped over all three of them.
Now Cruz is getting him back in the ring here.
Trying to, he's got him back in.
Who will win this, Lake or Cruz? Oh, it tells him to come at him. Wait, what? Oh,
good God. What?
Into an ankle lock.
Cruz has got an ankle lock.
What a maneuver there.
He's got it locked in.
Is Lake going to tap out right here?
Referee.
Did he get the ropes?
Is he going to get the ropes?
He got the rope break. Lake, with those long arms of his, got the rope break here, folks.
Cruz trying to get up to his feet right here. Oh, what an elbow to the face of Lake.
Oh, elbow strikes. Oh, good God. Ground
hammer strikes now.
Hammer strikes. Ground and pound.
It's like a pin. One, two. Lake kicks out at two.
Lake kicks out at two right there, folks. Yes, sir.
What an action-packed main event so far.
Action-packed.
Kicking right there. Wait. Oh! Wait, he catches it.
He's going to go for it. I know this. He's going to go for the surfboard. Surfboard face crusher.
Oh!
The surfboard face crusher connects.
Oh, my gosh.
Head first to the canvas.
He's rolling him over.
One, two.
Oh!
He kicks out.
That was amazing how Cruz went for that spinning kick right there and Lake caught it into the surfboard.
He got him by that surfboard face crusher. His face at the canvas.
They know each other better than anybody else.
You don't say. They've been at this for about 5 or 6 years now. I would imagine so there, Scott. And now.
And oh, he rolls over him. Oh, my gosh. Eat the feet.
Eat the feet. Foot right to the mush.
Lake's face must be in pain there. After that.
It must be in pain all over. Could you imagine?
After they eat the feet, now Cruz back on him with them elbow strikes to the face. And now he's going up top.
He's going to the top here, folks.
Oh my gosh. What's he gonna do?
What in the world? He's not gonna.
Leg better watch out below.
What in the world is he gonna do? Better watch out. He's high above. Swanton! Oh, oh, missed Mr. Swanton.
Oh my gosh, he's going for the pinfall. One, two,
no!
Oh my gosh. And Cruz is angry. He's angry.
He's pissed, irate.
The dude is pissed.
He didn't get that swanton.
They're both back to their feet right here. Looks like we're going to get a standoff here. Wait, oh my God, double clothesline.
Double clothesline by both.
Both men are down.
Both men are down on the canvas like
this. This is awesome.
It is awesome. What a main event. Look at that. Everyone. One, two.
Cruz kicks out there.
Like I said earlier, this is a human demolition derby, folks. Both men are using their bodies, put everything on the line for this main event match.
He's picking him up on his shoulders.
Oh my God, look out.
He lands it!
Oh, good
Pele.
God!
Pele! What a Pele kick by Cruz Lewis there.
Pele kick right to the face.
And now Lake trying to get up here.
He's been rattled. He's
in the corner. Cruz Lewis looking over him.
Look out. Oh!
Stomps to the gut. To the gut right there.
Wait a minute. Look out. He's sizing him up here for God knows what. Oh! A cannonball
by Cruz Lewis. And now both – he's working over him. Sorry, my bad right there.
He's going for
– one, two.
Oh, kick two. Out there.
Kick out there by Lake Lewis.
Now he's on top of him.
Good God, ground and pound UFC style. And now,
is he going back up to the top?
Oh, no, he's going up top.
It's risky business up there, Cruz. I want, don't do it again.
Watch out. Oh, a super kick.
A super kick. Oh, he got it right on the chin.
He could have knocked him out.
Oh, no, he's picking him up. What's he going for? DDT.
DDT.
Spikes it.
Head first.
One, two. They're pulling out everything in their arsenal here tonight on Rampage.
They're pulling out everything but the kitchen sink in this one.
Let's go.
And now, Lake on his knees, Cruz on. Oh,
trying to beat down his brother out there.
He's trying to get the W, folks.
They have gave everything here tonight.
What a chop!
What a chop there. Oh, an elbow strike.
And what's Lake gonna come back with? Oh, an elbow.
There's an elbow. Oh, bad punch.
They both got impacted right there. Both men in the corner. Oh, coming in with a spinning kick.
Spin kick right there. That tour jumps in the air, that spin kick. Oh, that was the question mark kick, but whatever it was, he got it.
That was not a question mark kick right there, I don't believe.
Look out!
Gonna come back. Oh,
handspring elbow. Good God.
Cruz Lewis.
He's pulling all the stops in this one.
Oh, no. Here he goes again.
Big blow.
And now. Going for this wheelbarrow. Wait.
Look out.
Super kick. He just ate feet.
He just ate a foot. He ate a shoe sandwich.
He could have knocked him out again there, folks.
Could have knocked him out.
And now he's picking him up. What's he going to do right here?
Wait a minute.
Oh, no.
Torture rack-like position. Good God, what in the world?
Knee to the face.
A torture rack, almost like a GTS
reverse GTS.
Yeah, there you go. Reverse GTS, got him with that torture rack position with the knee right in the face.
The Lake is picking up Cruz.
What's he going for right here?
Oh, he's
punching him off.
Using them forearms. Pushes him off.
Comes back with the kick.
Oh, there's the kick right there. It's got Lake Lewis rocked. It's got him
Cruz
rocked.
Looking over. Oh, what a knee.
What a knee right there.
Oh, my gosh. And now.
Look out.
Oh, no. He grabs him. Irish whip comes back. Oh my God. German suplex by Lake Lewis.
Lake Lewis with a German suplex there.
Oh my gosh. That was awesome.
What a great, beautiful German-like suplex that was by Lake to Cruz. What's next, folks?
Here he goes.
Wait a minute.
Looks like he's going for the Oh, wait, he misses.
Ready breaker miss. Look out. Here he goes. Raven's rim kick.
Oh, my God. He goes down. He goes down. Is this it right here? Hey, is this me. It? Is this it?
Come on.
One. No.
Kicks down at one.
Holy crap. Lake is still in it. No. Oh, my gosh.
He's still in. He's still standing. Still walking.
And he's got. Oh, wait. He catches him.
And look out.
Oh. Carry
neckbreaker.
Farmer carry neckbreaker. Cruz back to his feet. He's grabbing him right here.
Look out.
There he goes.
Look out. Incoming.
And a raybreaker.
Raybreaker.
He goes down.
That could be the.
This is it.
That could be all.
One. Two. Three.
And Lake Lewis has defeated his brother in this third encounter, maybe the final one, with the Rainbreaker.
What a main event for TBW Rampage, the 2K subscriber special.
What a main event match. These two brothers put out the absolute best in each other. Like we said, this is the third, maybe the final encounter, but who knows? There could be a fourth one.
What a match that was. I'm proud to call that one. Hats off to you both, Lake and Cruz. What a phenomenal match.
Wait a minute.
That might just be match of the year.
Lake now up to his feet. Cruz up to his feet. Wait a minute. Extends the hand. Shot of respect and an embrace. It's an embrace. That's what we like to see. No damn sneak attacks. No attack. No chairs. A man-to-man, brother-to-brother, friendly battle, and it ends with a handshake and embrace.
Lake Lewis gets the winner over Cruz here tonight on Rampage. We will see you next week.
Next week, there will not be a Rampage, but there will be the welterweight tournament.
Yeah, we will see you next week at the welterweight tournament.
Welterweight tournament, WF guys will be here, T-Lady guys will be here. The welterweight title, who's going to walk out with it, find out in the welterweight tournament. Good night, everybody. We'll see you there.
We'll see you next week.